Thank you. So, yes, when it comes to my equipment, when it comes to my cable equipment, I have a V bar, which is for tricep pull downs. I also use them for biceps and for front lat pull downs. The flat bar, which you can do the same thing, triceps, biceps, pull downs, and then I also have the handles. So I have basically every different variation of cable machines for lats and for triceps, and I also have the lat pull down bar, so I got all of them. But I find rowing gives you better lats than anything else, because I've literally done pull down lat machine for like years, never got anything. I started doing rows and all of a sudden boom, I'm starting to get them. So yeah, I think this bar specifically for pull downs is pointless. Just my opinion, but yes, I do have all those bars. And any other questions, comments, concerns, let me know and I will answer.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right. I need to. Hello. Red screen, red flag. Yeah, that's Spotify. That's my Spotify account. And if you would like to check it out, it is a public account. It's called Double Buffed. Ha ha ha. Like buff and buffing a computer. If you want to check that out, you can. I tried to do YouTube, but YouTube just has way too many ads and it's every like half song, so it's a piss off. Carbs, no, not tonight's lemon Caesar salad. Oh my God, it's gonna be so good. Can't wait. And what else is tonight? There's two more things. What's other than food tonight? What is it? Saturday night? So what is it? Come on. What is it? Leafs and Habs and Israel Adesanya against, I don't know, Poirier or whatever. But from what I've heard, and this could be, I do not believe that this is actually rumor. I think this is a fact. I just haven't went into the details. I believe that Vincent Kennedy McMahon has officially sold the WWE to the group Endeavor, who is planning on merging it with the UFC. That's what I've heard. He didn't retire. He came back. The rapist came back to kick people off his board because he's a misogynist and he had to pull power ranks in order to sell it. Yep. So I love the people like, Vince is such a smart guy. The guy's like a fucking, like he, a proven rapist. And they're all like, he's so cool. The mentality of WWE Orphers is so immature, it's pathetic. I actually responded to people on Facebook because they're like, I can't wait for WrestleMania. I'm like, so what? You're going to have a bunch of fucking celebrities come in and screw over the workers? Oh, why do you have to say it like that? Because it's the truth. It's a joke. Like, you get fucking, but Pat McPhee in there that beats up a guy. Like, are you kidding me? People are like, who's Pat McPhee? Exactly. But he gets a main event status on WrestleMania. It's all about the money. It has nothing against, it's nothing about nothing other than money for now for them. But yes, I believe that crossover matches, yeah, and also the fact that like sports betting is a big thing. So imagine how fast it's going to take before the corruption is going to hit. WWE and UFC and sports betting. Holy crap, that's just a dumpster fire. Like, I'm never going to be, I'm glad I don't gamble because there's going to be so many people losing money off like. Off of predetermined matches, like it's gonna be worse than boxing. It's just gonna be fucking brutal. That's why like all these people are leaving now. It's like, no, we're good. It's literally just money fights. Rankings mean nothing. Yes, WWE is scripted. That's what I'm saying. UFC is gonna turn into WWE if they merge. It's like you're putting a scripted sport because they hit each other with UFC, and you also have UFC being a massive thing with Bet365. So you don't think there's going to be like corruption in that? They've already had people. UFC's already had to fire people because of the fact that they were caught betting on, like coaches were caught betting against their own fucking fighters because they knew information beforehand. Like, if anybody actually believes that like the UFC is not corrupt, is holy crap. It should be, I guess you're a Democrat. Because it's like the Hillary Clinton. If I feel I am. You try that mental shit. Yeah, speaking of Hulkster, say your prayers, eat your vitamins, screw your buddy's girlfriend. And yes, that did happen. He actually had to go to court because he basically was banging his buddy's girl while the buddy was in the office, but they taped it and it's actually on YouTube. You can actually watch it. And then Hulkster, Mr. I don't take steroids, goes on the stand with a nice cross. I love people that wear the cross on their necklace when they're like literally like the worst of the worst. It's like Will Smith, Big Willie style. No, you're a cuck. You're a cuck, and you went on national TV and proved that you're a cuck. From bad boys to who's sucking my girl's dick now? It is. It's sad, but basically the way the world is now is no longer about proving something. You know what I mean? Like it used to be about your intelligence and proven science. Now it's about that's it. Okay, here's a great conspiracy here. Here's a great thought. You know Yazimata or Yakamoto, that Asian referee who literally like got fired because he was so bad? Now think about this. Imagine how many refs could bet on UFC matches and force people to get up from being ground dominant, stop people from being against the cage. You tell me that is not actually a possibility that all these refs or people knowing refs, close friends, here, I'm gonna give you some money. Why don't you call it this way and then I'm gonna make $10,000 on it. Because a ref can literally stop a fight, give somebody proper position if he wants, or take dominant position away by definition. They have the most control over a UFC fight. So who's going to say that refs aren't going to get involved in betting? Just like a ref in boxing. Oh, your eyes look glossy, you're done. But I'm fine. Nope, according to me, you're not. Think about it. I think it's going to get so bad, it's going to be brutal. Alrighty. Blind can't blind you. I'll have to do it the other way. Boom. Alright. I appreciate all the likes, follows, and comments. I should be back tonight watching the Leaf game and Habs, depending on how I feel. If not, I will for sure be back tomorrow and Monday. So I hope everyone is having a good long weekend. Any questions, comments, concerns, you let TJ know. Besides that, I appreciate the likes, the follows, the subs, and the comments. Keep it on your end. I'll keep it on my end. A beautiful relationship with none of the social media shit. Till tomorrow, lift heavy, lift strong, most of all lift, and be safe. Muscle Daddy out.